Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part one of graphing absolute value functions. So this is the basics. We begin by graphing f of x equals absolute value of x, and y equals absolute value of x minus 3, and we generalize how to graph for equations of the form f of x equals absolute value of x plus k. All right, so let's graph this function, f of x equals absolute value of x. Now, remember, you could just write that as y equals absolute value of x. That's the same exact function. You could always replace f of x with y and vice versa. So, what does this look like? Well, let's just plug in some ordered pairs and get an idea of what it might look like. So we'll pick some values for x and some values for y. So I'm going to put in some numbers, some positive and negative numbers for x. So how about we take the integers from negative 3 to 3, and this will at least give us some ordered pairs. So go ahead and write down what the absolute value of x is going to be. Remember, y is the absolute value of x. So for the first one, you're taking the absolute value of negative 3, which is 3. Okay? Remember, because y is the absolute value of x. So we get 3 when we plug in negative 3. So go ahead and fill out the rest of these numbers on your own. And hopefully you got the absolute value of negative 2 is 2, absolute value of negative 1 is 1, absolute value of 0 is 0, etc. So the first thing you might notice is all the y values are non-negative. They're not negative, are they? Because it's an absolute value of something, and absolute value can never be negative. It does go down to 0 because the absolute value of 0 is 0, and 0 is still not negative. It's not a positive number, but it's not negative. So let's go ahead and graph these ordered pairs. So we have negative 3, 3, negative 2, 2, negative 1, 1, 0, 0. Then we have 1, 1, we have 2, 2, and we have 3, 3. So it looks sort of like a V. And in fact, it is. If you graph enough points, like 1,000 points, you'll see that you get it looking like this. And that is the basic look of an absolute value function. It has this V shape. So this is the graph of y equals absolute value of x, or f of x equals absolute value of x. Now let's analyze this. Let's think about it. What is the domain of x? All right, is there anything I can't put in for x, in other words, or can I put every number in the world in? And you can put anything in the absolute value. So actually, the domain is all the real numbers. I'll just put all reals. Okay, what about the range? What are the values of y? Well, if you look at this picture, notice y is never below 0, right? Never goes below the x-axis here. And that's because the y is the absolute value of something, and absolute value is always greater than or equal to 0. So this will be all numbers greater than or equal to 0. In fact, I'm going to put both of these in interval notation and make it simple. The domain of x is in between negative infinity and infinity, and the range, the smallest number is 0, and it goes up forever. So the range goes between 0 up through infinity. And this, of course, is just a sketch. My graph paper here that I've shown here is freehand, so it's not perfect, but it should look symmetric across the y-axis as well. So if you have a point on the right side, it does end up having a point on the left side, this particular function. So let's try another one. So here's the next problem. You could also write this as f of x equals, I'm just going to write y. Y equals absolute value of x minus 3. So go ahead and try that. You could put in the same values, or you could put in other values in. Maybe you'll put in negative 4 and negative 3, negative 2. I'll just give you some ideas. You could pick any numbers you want for x. because you could put any number inside the absolute value. Right, so we have to be careful here. When you plug in negative 4, y is the absolute value of negative 4 minus 3, which is 4 minus 3, which is 1. So I'm just showing all the steps here. I don't think everybody needs to do that. Let's see, that was a minus 3. There we go. So when you put in negative 4 for x, y is 1. So where would that be? We've got negative 4 up 1. All right. What happens when you plug in negative 3? Let's see if we could do that in our head without showing all those steps. We'll plug in negative 3 in the absolute value, which is 3, and 3 minus 3 is 0. So my next point I've got here is negative 3, 0, which is right here. How about negative 2? So we're going to plug in negative 2 for x. The absolute value of negative 2 is 2, so 2 minus 3 is negative 1. So I now have the ordered pair, negative 2, negative 1. Plugging in a negative 1 for x, we get absolute value of negative 1, which is 1 minus 3. That gives me a negative 2. So I've got negative 1, negative 2. Plugging in 0, we have 0 minus 3. It's negative 3, so I've got this ordered pair. And then plugging in 1 for x, that'll give me a 1 minus 3 or negative 2. So I've got 1, negative 2. It looks like it's starting to go back up right here. And in fact, it does. So if we continued here, we would get negative 1, 0, and 1. Okay, and so if we kept on going here, I would have these values right here. Let's say I went up to 4, 1. Is that right? Yes. Okay, so we get the same shape as we did for y equals absolute value of x. What's the only difference? Well, everything was shifted down 3 spaces. In other words, this right here is y. My pen is not doing what it's supposed to. Y equals absolute value of x minus 3. And if I were going to graph y equals absolute value of x, remember what that looked like? This is y equals absolute value of x. So it's exactly the same graph, but everything is shifted down 3 spaces. If you've done parabolas, it's exactly the same thing. It's like if you had y equals x squared, that parabola, y equals x squared minus 3, it's sort of shifted down 3 spaces. So you want to know the basic look of the absolute value function, y equals absolute value of x, which I have in green. And if you have minus 3, it'll be shifted down 3 spaces. And if it's like plus 1, it'll be shifted up 1 space or etc. So if you just have the absolute value of x inside of here, this works. Now, what about the domain and range? Let's just go ahead and do the domain and range for the graph shown. All right, so we're looking at the blue graph here. X could be anything. And in fact, when you're doing absolute value functions, that's always going to be anything you can plug in for x. But the range is a little bit different. The y values, you can go as low as negative 3. So you notice this number here, which is subtracted, that'll be the lowest value of y. And here's why. This absolute value, the smallest thing that could be in the absolute value, when you take the absolute value, could be a 0, right? If you take the absolute value of something, it'll be a ne never a number smaller than 0. So whatever's in the absolute value, smallest number is 0, but then you could subtract 3 from that. And that's how I get that lowest point here at negative 3. Now, this spot right here where it changes direction, it looks sort of like a line, right? But it doesn't continue. It changes. There's kind of a V right here, and that's actually called the vertex. So the vertex of this parabola here is 0, negative 3. The vertex on y equals absolute value of x is at 0, 0. So that's called the vertex. That's the place where it changes. So here we have it in general. If we have f of x equals absolute value of x plus k, now remember, k can be a positive number or a negative number. The domain can be anything, right? All real numbers, negative infinity to infinity. But there's this lowest point on the graph, which is at k. So we know that it's along the y-axis because I just have absolute value of x here. So I don't know where the x-axis is. That would depend on if k is a positive or negative number. So this is the basic shape. The range then would be from k to infinity, and the vertex point is also 0, k. So we will be going over a lot more graphs of absolute value functions where maybe there's something like 2x minus 3 in the absolute value, there might be a minus sign in front of the absolute value, etc., on the next videos. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.